Look over here now. Nothing. Shalom.
Shalom. First and foremost, all praise, glory, and honor be unto Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushai, Bahashim Rakai Kodesh. Double honors to the elders and the apostles of the great millstone, Ruel. Salutations to the hopefully elect out there pushing this word in truth and sincerity and indeed. Your brother Chapatazai from the great millstone branch here in Chicago, coming at you with another quick, Lord willing, edifying lesson. And as you can see here, I'm going to hit this video again. There's an orchestrated famine going on, and it's just going to get worse, okay? We've been prophesying these things to happen through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, you know, for years now. All right, take a look.
Nothing, Akin.
This is coming from GMS Nothing. South Georgia. Look at that.
It's talking about a famine. Look at this shit, man. Nothing. Nothing.
And that looks like Walmart, you know, as we know, you know, the neighborhood Walmart is one of the most busiest stores that you can find. It's one of the biggest franchises in America, okay? And it's suffering that shortage because goods are not coming in as normal, all right? This is all being orchestrated, of course, by the elites, but they're putting the squeeze on people, okay? And the squeeze is just going to get tighter and tighter and tighter, okay? The laws are going to become more and more draconian. There's going to be more mandates. There's going to be more overall influence and complete domination of society by the elites. You've been given the illusion for the longest that you were free and that, you know, everything was all right. But that's just not the case. All right. Yahweh Bashem Yahushai is turning things up. He's allowing this devil to show his horns more. And this devil sees that he has a short time, as it is written. Therefore, he's going to come down with great wrath upon the inhabitants of the earth. But what? In that scripture, matter of fact, I'm going to get it. I ain't going to talk about it. I'm going to be about it. You know what I mean? Let's talk about it. All right, this is the book of Revelation. Wait, hold on. Matter of fact. Salaki, I believe it's Revelation 12 and 12. Alright. This is the book of Revelation chapter 12, verse 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Who's that talking about? That's talking about the elect hopeful. Okay? We're sitting in the heavenly places because what? Our minds is on Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Our minds is on the kingdom. You know, therefore we sit in heavenly places with Yahweh Shai, as it is written in the New Testament. Okay? So it's talking about ye heavens and ye that dwell in them. It says, woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath because he knoweth that he hath but a short time. All right. And this is part of the devil orchestrating these famines. That's a part of great wrath that he's getting ready to have.
Nothing, Akin.
All right. Nothing. Okay. This is a part of it. Okay. He knows his time is almost up, man. So he's going to do his best to push his agenda. You see that? All right. But he's going to fail. But in the midst of all this, there's going to be great and mass judgment upon 2/3 of our own people. You Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that refuse to repent and obey the words of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. They're going to suffer great judgments. Okay. What? The heathens, they're going to suffer great judgments. Okay. All right. The Idumeans, the chief of the heathen. All right. The enemy of all the earth. All right. Hey, their judgment is coming. They're going to suffer great judgments, man. And a lot of people, they didn't see these things coming through the years, especially 2020. All that money being handed out. Hey, man, niggas thought it was sweet. You know, this is the book of 2nd Ezra, chapter 16, verse 21. It says, behold, victuals shall be so good cheap upon earth that they shall think themselves to be in good case. Right. Because what, man? Hey, man, shit was booming. Hey, there was money being handed out. Niggas was getting stimulated. All right. Them damn PPP loans was going crazy. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, women was getting their BBLs, plastic surgery and shit. You know, niggas was flossing, buying cars, all kind of shit. They thought it was all good. But what does the scripture say? It says, and even then shall evils grow upon earth, sword, famine, and great confusion. Okay, so famine is getting ready to really touch. Okay, people are going to really start to feel it, man. And it's going to get more and more serious by the day. All right, people are going to wake up and realize that, damn, this is not a game. Okay, it's getting harder and harder out here to eat. All right, and then what? Shit gets cutthroat real fast here in America. Shit is going to get racial real fast here in America. All right. You're going to have a great division real fast here in America. Okay. And guess what? Them guns is going to go off real fast here in America. Okay. This shit is not a game, man. It's getting ready to get real. And a lot of people are getting ready to starve to death in the very near future. Okay. This is the book of Lamentations, chapter 4, verse 9. They that be slain with the sword are better than they that be slain with hunger. For these pine away, stricken through for want of the fruits of the field. See that? To pine away means to die slowly. Okay, to have your life force just flow out of you slowly, man. And that is terrible. Okay? The sword is better. To be shot is better than that. To get your head cut off is better than that. To be cut asunder is better than that, man. Okay, it's a slow, painful death of your body eating away at itself. It's going to eat the fat, and then your body's going to start to eat away at its organs, man, and you're just going to be through, okay? You're going to be finished, man. This is coming to a lot of people, all right? Verse 10, the hands of the pitiful women have sodden their own children. They were their meat in the destruction of the daughter of my people. See that? To sod, to boil. Okay, you're going to have women boiling and eating their own children. Okay, because what? There's going to be great destruction. There's going to be a great dearth and famine all throughout America. Okay, shit, chiefly all around the world, but especially here in America. All right, because what? Yahweh Hashem Yahushai has a great controversy over in this place, man. He has a controversy with the Idumeans. He has a controversy with these wicked ass heathen. And he has a controversy with these wicked ass children of disobedience. And you 2/3 Israelites, man, that refuse to repent, that continue to backslide, that continue to scoff and mock the men of the Lord. Okay. Oh yeah. They're all going to pay. Everybody's going to get their judgment. Okay. The reward, the Lord is going to render to every man the works of their own hands, whether it be good or whether it was evil. Okay, so call all Yahweh Hashem Yahushai for the Holy Spirit. All right, that keeps us, man, the hopeful elect, that keeps us geared towards pushing this truth, man. Okay, towards keeping our conduct and our conversation right, so that we may be found blameless in that day. Okay, because it's coming. All right, it's coming. Shit, it's here. Salaki, it's here. It's here. He's
talking about a famine. Look at this shit.
The fucking famine. It's here, man. All right. Now it's time to really buckle down, man. Now we finna see. We finna see who the Most High is really dealing with now. So with that, all praises, glory, and honor to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. Matter of fact, before I end it, I gotta get it. I gotta get it, man. All right. Just to balance it out. It ain't all doom and gloom for everybody. No, this is going to be a blessing to some. All right. This is, hey, man, it's time to shine for the hopefully elect, man. This is where, hey, man, the hopefully elect get the last laugh. All right. This is Isaiah chapter 65, verse 13. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, behold, my servants shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Behold, my servants shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty. Behold, my servants shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. You see that? All right. Man. How about Shemiel Shai? He's about to flip the script. Look at that. Look at that.
Nothing.
The servants of the Lord gonna eat. We gonna eat, man. All right. Verse 14. Behold, my servants shall sing for joy of heart, but ye shall cry for sorrow of heart and shall howl for vexation of spirit. You see that? All right, so the big payback, the big I told you so. All right, it is right around the corner. Okay, and the prophets are going to be in good case. All right, the rest of the world is going to be vexed and lamenting, weeping, gnashing of teeth. the men of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai and the hopefully elect man, hey, they're gonna be straight. They're gonna eat. Okay? So hey man, shit, bottoms up. All right. Lord willing, this was edifying. Shalom and Baba Ball. Amen. Death to 2/3.